So welcome everyone to AID live sessions. Okay, so last time we completed chapter 5, agroclimatic zones, and as I promised, after 6th of July we are starting a new chapter, that is chapter 6, which is cropping systems and patterns. Okay, so before starting the chapter, let's just wait for 1 minute for rest of the people to join. And once they join, we will just go ahead with this topic. Okay, this is a very, very important topic. Okay, because directly some of the static related questions are asked in not only objective part in the NABARD exam, but also some of the subjective questions are also asked from this area. Okay, and moreover, this topic of cropping systems as well as pattern is somewhat very, very core to agriculture. Okay, so we will totally see as well as learn holistically this subject also, various terms which are related, as well as we will go deep into the topics which are related to whole of this chapter. Okay, just let me know that am I audible or not. Yeah, good evening to everyone. Am I audible? Just let me know. Am I audible? Good evening everyone. Just let me know if I am audible or not, please. We'll quickly start the session. Just let me know audible hu kya, aawaz aa raha hai theek se, hum shuru karte hai lectures fir. Theek hai, let's go, let's quick start this chapter, very, very important chapter, chapter number 6, cropping systems and cropping patterns. Okay, so as we all know that you could go through our courses through the app as well as the new noble initiative of live classes for RBI, SEBI as well as NABARD. Okay, each of the core subjects are taken by the faculties. Management has been taken by Parul ma'am, ESI has been taken by Anuj sir, management has been again for SEBI has been taken by Parul ma'am, complete paper 2 syllabus has been taken by Chetan sir, ARD as you may have seen the chapter 5 which we have completed, of course I am taking the ARD section, and ESI again Anuj sir will take the section. So join the live classes, you all would have taken the experience also and also learned that what is the difference between the live classes and recorded classes. Okay, and now let's move towards the table of content of our today's topic, that is cropping systems and patterns. Okay, so what we are going to learn today, let's first analyze that what we are going to learn today. So first we are going to see what cropping patterns are, second we are going to see what cropping systems are, then we are going to see what is the difference between cropping system and cropping patterns. Okay, pehle hum dekhenge cropping pattern hai kya, fir cropping system kya hai, aur fir hum dekhenge dono mein difference kya hai. Theek hai, this is very, very crucial to understand whole of this topic. If you understand the concept, basic concept only here in this first 3 main topics in the table of content, then you would be able to understand different types of cropping pattern. You would be able to relate different examples to the different types of cropping pattern, etc, etc. Okay, so in today's, then we will see the factors affecting cropping pattern. So we have also seen factors affecting the agroclimatic zone, factors on which the classification was done of agroclimatic zone. Similarly, we will see the factors on which the cropping patterns would be depending, right? And I'll tell you one more thing, additional thing, that these factors are similar to those factors which were for agroclimatic zone itself. Okay, there are some minute changes, but the factors are same. Now, how they are same? It is because what is agroclimatic zone? It was nothing but a region telling you which suitable crops and how they should be grown. And that is nothing but cropping pattern and cropping system. So both are little bit related. Okay, then we are going to, in those factors, we are going to see geographical factors. Then economic factors, then we are going to see political factors, governmental policies which also influence the cropping patterns as well as cropping systems. Then we are going to see some of the historical factors, okay? And then we will go for classification, major cropping systems in India, some crops combinations which are widespread and very common in the Indian subcontinent, as well as then we will see generalized cropping combination in the country, okay? So this is whole of our three lessons in which we are going to complete our cropping systems and patterns, okay? So good evening Saurabh, good evening. Okay, now what we are going to do is that we'll just start the lesson, okay? So the first content which I told you, through which we are going to start, is cropping patterns, okay? So what are cropping patterns? Matlab cropping patterns kya hai, theek hai? So first let's break the word. First is cropping, second is pattern. Matlab kya? Cropping karne ke kuch patterns honge, right? So usko wo cropping pattern bulayenge, am I right? So let's first understand what cropping pattern is, okay? It is a yearly sequence and spatial arrangement of crops or crops and follow on a given area. Up some of the students will say that, sir, we are not getting it, or we are not understanding it. It's very very simple. See, what is cropping pattern? There are only two aspects of cropping pattern. Cropping pattern ke bas do aspects hai, ye dekho. So two aspects only. First is spatial. Spatial means space. What it means is that when from one region to another region, the crop selection as well as cropping of different crops changes according to space, it is spatial. And when the cropping changes according to time, it is called as temporal. And cropping patterns has this both aspect. Matlab kya? When, suppose if you compare two regions in the country, in India, if you compare two regions, and if the cropping pattern or the cropping choices, selection and different methods through which the cropping is done, if this changes through the space as well as through the time, matlab thode saal ke baad change ho gaya, 10 saal, 20 saal ke baad change ho gaya, then after certain area, after crossing one region to another region, it also changed. Matlab aap ek region se dusre region chale gaye, north se south chale gaye, east se west chale gaye, to bhi cropping patterns change ho gaye. आपने दो 2010 में देखा कि नॉर्थ में क्या क्रॉपिंग हो रहा था, आपने 2022 में देखा कि नॉर्थ में क्या हो रहा था, सिमिलरली साउथ में, सिमिलरली सेंट्रल इंडिया में. सो इट इज स्पेशियल एज वेल एज इट इज टेम्पोरल. सो लेट्स टेक एन एग्जांपल. सो दिस इज अ पैच ऑफ लैंड. कंसिडरिंग दिस पैच ऑफ लैंड ए, सो कंसिडरिंग दिस पैच ऑफ लैंड ए, सपोज इन जून टू मार्च, सपोज जून टू मार्च वन क्रॉप इज ग्रोन. लेट्स कंसिडर जून टू मार्च we have grown some zaid crops, okay, because it is generally summer time, okay. Then April, suppose second crop was grown from April to June, this may be a kharif crop, okay. Then from June to October, suppose rabi crop is grown, okay. So for this 3 months, three different crops are grown, okay. So this is seasonal differentiation which we talked about, kharif, rabi and zaid crops, okay. So three crops temporal, that is according to time, right, you are changing the cropping pattern, okay. So cropping selection as well as cropping pattern. Now what is crop selection? Crop selection is simple. Suppose there is a farmer A and suppose there is a farmer B. Suppose farmer A decides that in this annual agricultural year, I am going to plant rice and wheat only two crops. But farmer B says that no, I am going to plant rice, wheat as well as some of the vegetables or some of the flowers, okay, vegetables such as cucumber or maybe muskmelon or maybe bottle gourd. I'll plant these also during the zaid cropping, okay. So farmer A is cropping two crops only, but farmer B is cropping three crops, okay. So when such patch of land, when you crop different crops according to space and different crops according to time, that time you may call it as cropping pattern, okay. Then you may call it as cropping pattern, okay. We are clear here? Farming systems we are going to cover. If it comes in first four chapters, I am going to again record the sessions of the first four chapters and I am going to upload those, okay. for just for now sake, just concentrate on which topic we are going on. Okay, so this is cropping pattern which we talked about. Now let's take an example. So if you see the eastern part or the Gangetic belt, as well as West Bengal region, as well as some eastern Uttar Pradesh region, if we talked about this particular region in context of agriculture, then you may see that in kharif season, this region rice is grown. Okay, in rabi season, wheat is grown, and in zaid season, that is now, if you see summers are going on, and in Delhi also you may see that cucumber, muskmelon, bottle gourd, carrot, radish, these are commonly seen today on the streets. Why? Because zaid season is going on. Okay, summers are going on, so short period crops you could see on the streets or near the vegetable vendors. Okay, so this is nothing but different crop selections or crop rotation has been done by the farmers. And when you select such crops and when you plant these crops in different patterns on your field, that is nothing but as cropping pattern. Okay, now let's see. Now what is change in space? So different regions, different crops are grown. We talked about in एग्रोक्लाइमेटिक जोन्स, हमने एग्रोक्लाइमेटिक जोन्स में बहुत देखा था कि डिफरेंट रीजन से हमें पता चलता है कि डिफरेंट क्रॉप्स ग्रो होते हैं. फॉर एग्जांपल, हम बहुत सारे एग्जांपल्स ले सकते हैं इसके लिए. हमने टी का एग्जांपल लिया था, शुगर केन का एग्जांपल लिया था, एमराइट, राइस, व्हीट, बहुत सारे क्रॉप्स और डिफरेंट डिफरेंट रीजन का एग्जाम्पल लिया था. सो दिस इज नथिंग बट चेंज ओवर अ स्पेस मीन्स स्पेशियल, एंड चेंज ओवर टाइम मीन्स एग्जाम्पल ऑफ ग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, बिफोर ग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन वेरियस कोर्स ग्रेन्स वेर ग्रोन, बट आफ्टर ग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन द सीरियल्स डॉमिनेटेड द फूड बास्केट ऑफ द कंट्री. राइस एंड व्हीट, देर वॉज अ स्पाइक इंक्रीज इन राइस एंड व्हीट. स्पाइक इंक्रीज इन द सेंस क्या, अगर आप ग्राफ को प्लॉट करोगे आफ्टर 1960s टू 2010, देर वॉज स्पाइक इंक्रीज इन राइस एंड व्हीट प्रोडक्शन. ओके, सो दिस इज नथिंग बट चेंज ओवर टाइम, दैट मीन्स टेम्पोरल. Okay, and yearly change in crop selection of the pattern. For example, farmer was doing in 2019 rice. Suppose farmer was doing rice in 2019. But suppose in 2020, farmer thought that tomatoes will give him more money, or tomatoes would be having good price in the market in 2021 or 2022. So therefore, farmer didn't did only rice. He also added tomatoes in his annual produce or annual field yield. Okay, then this is nothing but yearly change in crop selection as well as pattern. So at that stage, what farmer could do is that he may align one line of rice, then tomatoes, rice, then tomatoes. He may do intercropping of parallel two lines of rice and tomatoes. Okay, this is nothing but selection of crops and then change in the cropping pattern. Okay, earlier the farmer was doing only rice or wheat, but he was getting less profit. But now farmer thought that tomatoes are having good price in the market, so therefore he changed his cropping pattern. So this is what we are talking about. So see here, rice wheat could be a cropping combination, maize mustard could be a cropping combination, soybean chickpea could be a cropping combination. So according to this different combinations, crop selection, rotation and combination is done. And after that, then we understood the different cropping patterns are selected. So various cropping patterns are there. It may be intercropping. Intercropping matlab kya? A crop, uske baad dusra crop. A crop, B crop. Then A crop, then B crop. Right? What is mixed cropping? Mixed cropping means all the crops, different crops are selected and they are arbitrarily grown into a field. So there are various types of cropping patterns and we are going to learn them in depth. Okay, when the classification of the cropping pattern would be done. Now just understand what cropping patterns are. Okay, so let's go to our slide now. So in simple terms, it is the pattern of crops for a given piece of land. So if we take that piece of land which we talked about, and if we try to understand what are the different patterns of crops which are grown on the land, that is cropping pattern. Then proportion of area under various crop at a point of time. So if I go to a farm today, and if I see that in a crop, a cabbage is grown as well as a carrot is grown. So that is nothing but two crops are grown in line, in parallels, in a crop, in a field. Then we may say that this is the cropping pattern at that particular time. Okay, it is a dynamic concept because it changes over space and time, as we talked about. According to time it changes, and according to space also it changes. And how it changes? For example, now during this month of June to July, if you go to the North India, then different crops would have been grown, right? And if you go to South India, some different crops would have been grown. Similarly, different combinations of crops as well as different cropping patterns, because of those combinations, would have been grown into the field. So therefore, it is a dynamic concept. Then cropping pattern is determined by the rainfall, climate, temperature, soil type and technology, definitely, which we talked about. Now example, wheat, barley, gram, mustard, etc. are grown in Punjab and Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand and Uttar Pradesh region. We all know this region is nothing but Gangetic Belt region, good irrigation, good alluvial soil. So therefore, wheat, barley, gram, mustard, these are very, very high producing crops in this region. Similarly, cotton is grown in Maharashtra, jute is grown in West Bengal. So see, this is nothing but crop selection or crop suitability of particular crop to a particular region. Depending on that, different cropping patterns have evolved in those regions. Okay, now take a simple case study. When rice is grown when monsoons are good, but if monsoons fail, then instead of rice, as now monsoons have failed, less water would be there. So therefore, either legumes are produced or the millets are grown. Okay, and wheat and legumes are planted together on the same field, so that in the central India, as the water from the monsoons is very, very less. Okay, so from here you could understand how the crop selection has changed, and at the same time how the crop combination has changed, and how cropping pattern has also changed. So just take an example, agar 2020 mein bahut achhi barish ho gayi, aur agar humne bas rice aur wheat ka agar plantation kiya, and we got a good productivity as well as good produce out of it, okay, but at the same time, if next year if monsoon fails, then what farmer will do? Farmer will realize that yes, monsoon has failed, water available is very, very less. So what should I do? I shouldn't be planting more rice and wheat. Rather than that, I will plant wheat who requires less water, and along with that I will plant some millets, some coarse grains like bajra, ragi, and as well as I will also plant some legumes. And what will happen due to it? Legumes and millets require less water, and therefore they could be grown along with wheat. And at the same time, as earlier I was planting only rice and wheat, now I am planting three crops. So the cropping pattern will change from 2020 to 2021 or 2022. You understood? I think we are more than clear here. So you could see here the cropping pattern. See here, cropping pattern has been given. So first is cross checkered mark, this part. Okay, I think we all, I think we all are getting here. ये वाला part चल रहा है. Okay, this is the part. This is rice, jute and tea region. Okay, so in this particular region only rice, tea and jute is grown. So if you see, the cropping pattern of this region would be different than the rest of the regions. Okay, now second region, wheat, sugarcane region. See here, the slash border region, this one, the greenery, the alluvial soil irrigation, the rainfall from 150 to 200 centimeters, which we discussed in agroclimatic zone. Bhulna mat agroclimatic zone ko, aur pichle koi bhi chapters ko bhulna mat. Revise karo, scribble karte raho, apne notes banao. Theek hai? More you will revise the classes in the live sessions, more you will have the knowledge. Theek hai? Kuch bhi bhul ke aage aur fir se yahan par doubt pucha to kaise hoga? Right? So humne bahut wahan par extensively discuss kiya hai about the climate, about the soil, about different factors, which crops are grown where, etc, etc. Okay, so now this is the region. So you could see wheat, sugar, this is the wheat sugarcane region. Now cropping pattern here would be different than rest of the region. Similarly goes for cotton region. This is the cotton region. Similarly goes for maize and coarse crop regions. Maize and coarse crop region, this is maize and coarse crop region. Millet region is this, Karnataka. Karnataka is well known for its ragi, bajra, right? Such millets. Then fruits and vegetable region, which is this region, fruits and vegetable, cold climate, right? So this is nothing but the regional, or you may say geospatial, special like map has been drawn for different crops through which the cropping pattern of the country can be analyzed. Okay, now let's move to the next. Now comes what are cropping systems. Once you understand that what cropping patterns are, now let's understand what cropping systems are. Okay, so let's see what cropping systems are. So see here, time and space, which we talked about the cropping patterns, right? So temporal spatial arrangement of crops is nothing but cropping pattern. पूरी जो डिफिकल्ट डेफिनेशन थी, वॉट एवर डिफिकल्ट डेफिनेशन वॉज देयर ऑफ क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न्स, ओके, यू डोंट नीड टू रिमेंबर एनीथिंग, जस्ट दिस बॉक्स. टाइम एंड स्पेस, दैट मीन्स टेम्पोरल एंड स्पेशियल अरेंजमेंट ऑफ क्रॉप्स इज नथिंग बट क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न्स. खत्म. बस इतना ही याद रखना है. टाइम के अकॉर्डिंग क्रॉप्स का पैटर्न चेंज हो जाता है, स्पेस के अकॉर्डिंग क्रॉप्स का पैटर्न चेंज हो जाता है. इस अरेंजमेंट को क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न्स बोलते हैं. खत्म. टाइम, टेम्पोरल एंड स्पेशियल अरेंजमेंट ऑफ क्रॉप्स, डन. नाउ लेट्स सी व्हाट क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम्स आर. ओके, नाउ एवरीबडी विल आस्क वन कॉमन क्वेश्चन, सर व्हाट आर सिस्टम्स. सिस्टम्स क्या होता है? सिस्टम्स आर नथिंग बट सिस्टम्स आर हैविंग कंपोनेंट्स व्हिच वर्क इन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड वे टू अचीव एन ऑब्जेक्टिव. सो एक सिस्टम का नाम बताओ, कोई भी एक सिस्टम. प्रेशर कुकर, एम आई राइट, टी केटल, अ कप ऑफ टी, राइट, एनीथिंग इन दिस वर्ल्ड कुड बी अ सिस्टम. आपका मोबाइल, वो भी तो एक सिस्टम है. टीवी, गैजेट, कोई भी. हम ह्यूमंस भी तो एक सिस्टम है, राइट. सो एनी मॉडर्नाइज मशीनरी और एनीथिंग विच हैज कंपोनेंट्स विच वर्क्स इन एन ऑर्गेनाइज वे टू अचीव अ ऑब्जेक्टिव इज कॉल्ड एज सिस्टम. सो क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम मतलब क्या रहेगा? लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड वॉट आर क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम्स. So cropping systems are nothing but such components in the cropping or the in agriculture which are interrelated and whose interaction, that means cropping pattern and cropping yield of input to output shows, that means cropping systems kya rehte hai? Cropping pattern plus the management of the crops. You understood? Cropping patterns, we understood what cropping pattern was. And cropping systems are nothing but the interrelatedness and interaction of the cropping patterns. Okay, so let's understand through this slide. The term cropping system refers to crops, the crop sequences and the patterns along with the management techniques used for a particular agriculture field over the period of years. So क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न हमने देख लिया कि क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न क्या है. वी अंडरस्टूड व्हाट क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न इज. व्हेन यू से दैट क्रॉपिंग सीक्वेंसेस, क्रॉपिंग सिलेक्शन, क्रॉपिंग रोटेशन, क्रॉपिंग कॉम्बिनेशन एंड रिस्पेक्टिव क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न्स एंड यू मैनेज दीज क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न्स. एंड व्हाट इज मैनेजिंग दीज क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न मीन्स मैनेजिंग फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ रिसोर्स, मैनेजिंग फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ द health of the crops, that means efficient use of water, efficient use of fertilizer, right? Managing in the sense increasing the productivity of the agriculture, increasing the yield of the crops, right? This is nothing but the management. So cropping pattern plus management of such crops gives us total cropping system. It is a holistic system. Okay, so in general, if I want to draw what cropping patterns, so see here, these are cropping patterns. If you see, and if I add management here, management of crops, then this will give, this whole circle is cropping system. So you understood, we understood what cropping patterns are, then we added management of the crops. मैनेजमेंट ऑफ द क्रॉप्स, आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू, क्रॉप को मैनेज करना, उसको कोई भी डिसीज लगने ना देना, रिसोर्सेस को बहुत ऑप्टिमाइज्ड वे में यूज करना, उसकी यील्ड और प्रोडक्टिविटी को इंक्रीज करना, ठीक है. दिस होल सर्कल इन सर्कल इज नथिंग बट दिस कॉन्सेंट्रिक सर्कल इज क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम. व्हेन एवरी फार्मर विल ट्राई टू इनकॉर्पोरेट सच क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम, ऑटोमेटिकली द एग्रीकल्चर विल बिकम प्रॉफिटेबल. Now you understand why we are learning about cropping patterns. Now you understand why we are learning about cropping systems. I think we are more than clear here. Okay. So, spatial and temporal aspects of managing an agricultural system. What was the cropping pattern mean? It was nothing but spatial and temporal arrangement of crops. And if I do spatial and temporal management of crops, then it is nothing but crops as well as agricultural system, it is nothing but cropping system. To maximize the yield, but the modern agriculture is increasingly concerned with promoting environmental sustainability in the cropping system. So we learnt in 1970s, 1960s and 1990s, agriculture had become very commercial. Logon ko bahut profit chahiye tha. So green revolution jab aaya, no wonder we became food surplus country. But at the same time, the food basket became skewed, the interregional disparity, interpersonal disparity, soil infertility, excessive use of resources. Because of that, now the vision of the agriculturalists as well as the farmers has changed. Now it is not more about commercialization as well as exploitation of resources and exploitation of agriculture. Rather, it is improving the yields, it is improving the agricultural productivity by choosing sustainable means of agriculture as well as ecological balance. Okay, so therefore they are talking about cropping patterns and cropping systems. Now it is a holistic concept where the cropping pattern, techniques and choices are used. Okay, physical diversity and plurality of the cultures in India is reflected in the agricultural practices. Har region mein hum jayenge to agricultural practices change hongi, agricultural methods change hongi, agricultural techniques change hongi, crops change hongi, ऑटोमेटिकली क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न्स चेंज होंगे और ऑटोमेटिकली जब क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न चेंज होगा तो ऑटोमेटिकली क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम्स भी चेंज होंगी. जब क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम्स चेंज हो जाएंगी डिफरेंट डिफरेंट रीजन्स की, देन देयर वुड बी मोर डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर प्रोड्यूस ऑल्सो एंड एग्रीकल्चरल यील्ड ऑल्सो एज वेल एज क्रॉप्स ऑल्सो एंड द ग्रेन्स और द प्रोडक्ट्स विच वी गेट फ्रॉम द एग्रीकल्चरल फील्ड्स. ओके, सो वन ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल्स कुड बी विच वी डिस्कस्ड इन द एग्रोक्लाइमेटिक जोन्स ऑल्सो एंड नाउ ऑल्सो, दैट इज फॉर एग्जाम्पल ऑरेंजेस फ्रॉम नागपुर, एप्पल्स फ्रॉम कश्मीर, सैफरन फ्रॉम कश्मीर, पेपर फ्रॉम केरला, टी फ्रॉम आसाम, दार्जिलिंग टी विच हैज गॉट जी आई टैग, राइट, अल्फांसो मैंगोज फ्रॉम रत्नागिरी, जी आई टैग अगेन. सो दिस इज वॉट by doing agriculture in a holistic way. Okay, so cropping system we understood. So the cropping pattern used on farm and its interaction with the farm resources, other farm enterprises and available technology which determines their makeup. So what they are trying to generally say is that dekho cropping pattern to samajh mein aa gaya ki maine crop select kiye, rice wheat lagaunga aur main pulses lagaunga isi crop mein. 5 bigha zameen hai mere paas, I have 5 hectare field, I am going to plant rice, wheat and legumes. I decided my crops, now I am going to decide my cropping pattern. Okay, I am going to do cropping pattern of intercropping, rice along with legumes, wheat along with legumes, in annually two I will do such croppings. That means in kharif season I am going to do rice and legumes and in rabi season I am going to do wheat and legumes. This is my cropping pattern. After that cropping pattern, I am going to see which are the interaction with the farmer resources. For example, along with farming, what I am doing? Am I doing poultry? Am I doing domestication of other animals? Am I doing dairy? So I am going to also see ancillary activities which are interacting with my farm. Okay, and what will happen due to that? Isse ye hoga ki automatically my income and the livelihood will increase. At the same time, I could use different inputs from these ancillary activities and I could create an circular economy in agriculture itself. Okay, so second thing is other farm enterprises, for example cooperative farming or maybe use of agriculture technology. If I don't have tractor, then I can pull it from the cooperatives or self-help groups, right? Then available technology to determine the makeup. For example, I have 5 hectare land and for irrigation I need drip irrigation, so similarly this technology I could use. So all these things come together in the cropping systems. Okay, cropping systems is very very holistic term, right? Now the type and the sequence of the crop grown and the practices used to grow them refer to cropping system. It covers all the cropping sequences practiced over space and time based on the available crop production technologies. That it generally says that only what we discussed now. Okay, it's a holistic concept where cropping patterns only is about arrangement, cropping system is more about all the things which come into the interaction in an farm. For example, suppose ek farmer, there is a Prabhu Anna who is from Karnataka who is planting rice along with ragi. He uses tractor in his 10 hectare farm. He is also doing poultry along with his farming. Okay, he has joined self-help group so that he gets solar water pump from facility from that self-help group. Okay, at the same time he also gets some governmental schemes for his seeds as well as the poultry production which he does through his poultry. Okay, all these activities of Prabhu Adna from Karnataka is nothing but showing us the cropping system what he's carrying in Karnataka. Okay, so this is what it means. Then cropping system have been traditionally structured to maximize the crop yield. So ye Prabhu Adna jo cropping kar raha hai wo wheat ke sath sath ragi grow kar raha hai. At the same time wo eggs bhi sell karega, chicken aur hen bhi sell karega as he is doing poultry. So automatically his yield will increase. At the same time the poultry will also produce some of the fertilizers, right, which are nitrogen, having high nitrogen content. He can use that fertilizer for his crops also. So again a circular economy, automatically his yields are increasing. So example, horticultural cropping in Nashik and Aurangabad, in agroclimatic zones we talked about. Then vineyard cropping systems in Mediterranean Sea. Vineyard cropping in Mediterranean Sea, or maybe vineyard cropping which in even Jammu, Kashmir Valley. Okay, because Mediterranean Sea is also having valley relief, like relief structure or geographical description. So when you see the Mediterranean region of the world is well known for its wines, for its oranges, etc., etc. Okay, so this is nothing but a particular region showing you a particular crops are grown in a particular cropping pattern, which and the other systems which are related, they interact along these cropping patterns to show you a holistic cropping system. Okay, now the difference between, before that let's discuss the cropping system. So this was the thing which I wanted to stress, crops. Then cropping selection, which crops I am going to select. Prabhu Anna ki yaad nikalo, rice, wheat, and what he was growing, like ragi, right? Then cropping pattern. So for maybe for kharif he may be doing rice and ragi, and for rabi season he may be growing wheat and ragi. Okay, then management. And how come management he is doing? Management he is doing for resource use efficiency. He wants to use his resources very properly, judiciously, in most optimum way, so that his inputs are reduced and his outputs are high. Okay, this whole concept from A to B is nothing but cropping system. So try to understand how much important this concept is. ये क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम का जो कंसेप्ट है, ये अगर इंडिया में हर एक फार्मर अगर लगाएगा ना, तो कोई भी फार्मर कभी भी सुसाइड भी नहीं करेगा, एंड ही विल नेवर से दैट एग्रीकल्चर इज इन क्राइसिस एंड आई डोंट वांट टू डू फार्मिंग. सो दिस इज हाउ मच इंपॉर्टेंट दिस कंसेप्ट इज. ओके, नाउ लेट्स गो टू द क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम. सो जस्ट ट्राई टू रिमेंबर दिस थिंग, दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. दिस इज नथिंग बट द क्रक्स ऑफ द क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम. वॉट इज क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम? Cropping system is nothing but cropping pattern and its interrelatedness and interaction with the farm resource, the farm enterprises. Farm resource in the sense irrigation, fertilizers, seeds, etc., etc. Farm enterprises, self-help groups, right? Ancillary activities like poultry, dairy, etc., etc. Available technology, it may be tractor, it may be solar pump, it may be drip irrigation, etc. And environment also. And also environment. So why environment has come into picture? Again, sustainability and sustainable way to do a agriculture with ecological balance. So this is nothing but cropping system. So ye aap concept yaad rakhna, try at least take a screenshot out of it. Okay, jo important maine bataya crux hai, take the screenshots. Okay, so अगर किसी को कुछ भी नहीं समझा तो प्लीज लेट मी नो. आई थिंक एवरीबडी हैज अंडरस्टूड व्हाट वी आर ट्राइंग टू डू हियर. ओके. if you are having doubts, please let me know. This is the crux of the cropping system. That's it. कोई doubt है तो पूछ सकते हो, but I don't think there are any doubt because see the concepts are very very easy. Cropping pattern क्या है? Temporal and spatial arrangement. और cropping system क्या है? Cropping system is temporal and spatial management of that arrangement. Very very simple. अब समझा? Temporal, time और space का अगर मैं crops का arrangement करूँ तो वो हो गया cropping pattern. और अगर उनका इसी अरेंजमेंट का अगर मैं मैनेजमेंट करूं इकोलॉजिकल वे में, रिसोर्स के वे में, इंक्रीजिंग द प्रोडक्टिविटी के वे में, राइट, मेकिंग एग्रीकल्चर मोर फ्रूटफुल, राइट, इस वे में, दैट इज नथिंग बट क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम. वेरी सिंपल. ओके, सो नाउ लेट्स सी द डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन दी क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम्स एंड क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न्स. सो क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न, क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम. क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न मतलब क्या है? क्रॉप रोटेशन प्रैक्टिस बाय द मेजोरिटी ऑफ फार्मर इन अ गिवन एरिया और लोकेलिटी. क्रॉप रोटेशन वगैरह आप कंफ्यूज मत हो जाना, इट इज नथिंग बट क्रॉप अरेंजमेंट. सो क्रॉप की अरेंजमेंट आप डिफरेंट डिफरेंट टाइप से कर सकते हो. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आपने मिक्स कर लिया, आपने राइस व्हीट एक साथ लगा दिया, राइस व्हीट लेग्यूम्स एक साथ लगाया, ये मिक्स हो गया. आपने इंटरक्रॉपिंग कर लिया, आपने राइस लगाया फिर आपने व्हीट लगाया, आपने राइस लगाया फिर आपने व्हीट लगाया. फॉर और खरीफ में आपने क्या किया? राइस लगाया, लेग्यूम्स लगाए, राइस लगाया, लेग्यूम्स लगाए. रबी सीजन में आपने क्या किया? व्हीट लगाया, आपने मिलेट्स लगाए, व्हीट लगाया, मिलेट्स लगाए. एम आई राइट? सो दिस इज नथिंग बट इंटरक्रॉपिंग. व्हाट वुड बी द क्रॉप रोटेशन? क्रॉप रोटेशन में बी लाइक दिस. फॉर खरीफ सीजन आई डिड राइस, फॉर रबी सीजन आई डिड व्हीट, एंड फॉर जैद सीजन आई प्लांटेड कुकुम्बर एंड कैरेट्स. सो दिस इज नथिंग बट क्रॉप रोटेशन. आई एम रोटेटिंग माई फील्ड, इन माई फील्ड आई एम रोटेटिंग क्रॉप्स फ्रॉम राइस टू व्हीट टू कुकुम्बर एंड कैरेट्स, अगेन राइस, देन व्हीट टू कुकुम्बर एंड कैरेट. दिस इज क्रॉप रोटेशन. इट्स नथिंग बट सिलेक्शन ऑफ क्रॉप्स. सो दिस इज नथिंग बट क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न. सो क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न एंड इट्स इस क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न का जब हम मैनेजमेंट करते हैं फ्रॉम अ गिवन रिसोर्स बेस अंडर अ स्पेसिफिक एनवायरमेंटल कंडीशन, इट्स क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम. देन टाइप एंड मैनेजमेंट ऑफ क्रॉप्स इन टाइम एंड स्पेस, राइट, एंड क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न्स आर यूज्ड ऑन फार्म विथ इंटरेक्शन ऑफ फार्म रिसोर्सेज एंड अदर एंटरप्राइजेस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी अवेलेबल विच वी डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर. Then yearly sequence and spatial arrangement of crops and fallow on a given area. That means yearly, एक साल में in one particular agricultural year, which crops are selected, which crops in which pattern are grown. Simple, which we discussed already. And what is the cropping system का last point क्या है? Pattern of such crops for a particular land, which are cultivated for a fixed period and its interaction or its management is done. And management not just of crop, management of soil, management of crop, management of ancillary activities, management of its productivity, its yield, etc., etc. It's holistic management. Okay, now let's go to the next point. Now see the difference. Ab ek in short dekhte hai ki cropping pattern aur cropping systems mein difference kya hai. Okay, लेट्स इन शॉर्ट अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज क्रॉपिंग. क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न मतलब क्या? स्पेशल एंड टेम्पोरल अरेंजमेंट ऑफ द क्रॉप. क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम्स मतलब क्या? क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न प्लस मैनेजमेंट. मतलब ये क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न प्लस मैनेजमेंट. एंड मैनेजमेंट इन द सेंस वॉट? ऑल द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द क्रॉपिंग और द एग्रीकल्चर इट सेल्फ, दे कम एंड इंटरेक्ट एज वेल एज आर इंटर रिलेटेड इन द होल क्रॉपिंग सिस्टम. ओके, so this was nothing but the difference between cropping system and cropping patterns. Now factors which are affecting the cropping pattern, ab main pehle hi bata deta hu, these factors are very very similar to agroclimatic zone. Agar kisi ne kaha ki kuch samajh nahi aa raha hai and if you are not able to relate, then definitely fir hame ye sab chhod dena chahiye, kyunki in agroclimatic zones we have understood it by depth. So here I am not going to waste more time on this. Okay, so बहुत क्विकली ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, ट्राई टू इंटररिलेट द मल्टी डायमेंशनल अप्रोच. ओके, सी सेम फैक्टर्स आर देयर, कोई फैक्टर्स भी चेंज नहीं है. ज्योग्राफिकल फैक्टर, इकोनॉमिकल फैक्टर, रिलीफ, टेम्परेचर, सेम जो हमने एग्रोक्लाइमेटिक जोन में देखे थे. इफ नाउ यू आर विद डाउट, देन डेफिनेटली यू शुड गो एंड कंप्लीट द लेसन्स ऑफ द एग्रोक्लाइमेटिक जोन फर्स्ट. ठीक है, लेट्स स्टार्ट. सो फर्स्ट फैक्टर इज ज्योग्राफिकल फैक्टर एंड फर्स्ट इज रिलीफ. रिलीफ में हमने पहले ही डिस्कस किया था दैट हाउ रिलीफ, बिकॉज ऑफ द रिलीफ डिफरेंट एग्रोक्लाइमेटिक जोन्स एंड डिफरेंट क्रॉप्स चेंज. सिमिलरली बिकॉज ऑफ रिलीफ डिफरेंट क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न्स आल्सो चेंज. हाउ क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न्स चेंज बिकॉज ऑफ रिलीफ? सिंपल यार, नॉर्थ ईस्ट में अगर टी प्रोड्यूस हो रहा है तो तो वहां का क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न भी तो टी का क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न कैसे रहता है? टीज आर प्लांटेड ऑन दी टेरिस. इन लास्ट लेक्चर आई ऑलरेडी शोड यू दैट ट्रीज आर प्लांटेड ऑन द टेरिस, राइट. सो ट्रीज का ऐसे अगर ये नॉर्थ ईस्ट रीजन है तो इसका टेरिस फार्मिंग किया जाता है. तो टेरिस फार्मिंग इज नथिंग बट लाइक दिस एंड हियर द ट्रीज टी इज ग्रोन ऑन दी स्लोप्स. व्हाई? बिकॉज ट्री द टी कल्टिवेशन डजंट नीड वाटर स्टैग्नेशन, राइट. सो ऑटोमेटिकली क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न चेंज हो गया यहां पर. So we already have discussed all this. So tea coffee example you can take. You can take example of sugarcane in well irrigated region. Sugarcane कहाँ पे ज़्यादा grow होती है? Gangetic basin, right? ये relief हमने देखा है. I don't think relief में कोई doubt होगा किसी को, right? We have seen this. Then let's go to the next factor. Next factor is important factor, that is temperature. और temperature को भी बहुत deeply हमने agroclimatic zone में देखा था. How wheat, only a single crop, wheat for sowing, for harvesting and for growing. All the three different growth stages, it requires different temperature. For example, for sowing, it requires moderate temperature. For growing, it requires little bit less. For harvesting, it requires little bit high temperature. Okay? So, similarly, temperature during sowing, reaping is different. That's what? Of wheat, for example, which we discussed now. Most of the growth, so some crops require high temperature and are sown in summer season. Which are those crops which are grown in summer season? Nothing but kharif crop, because they require high temperature when they are sown. So therefore these summer crops mostly grown are kharif crops. Rice ho gaya, cotton ho gaya. Then there are other crops which require lower temperature during the sowing season. These are nothing but rabi crops. So wo kaun se crops ho gaye? Wheat ho gaya, right. So example such sugarcane gives higher yield in South India than Northern Plains. Now why this? Can anybody tell me ki aisa kyun hai karke? Sugar cane gives higher yield in South India than in Northern Plains. Why this occurs? Please let me know. ऐसा क्यों होता है? It happens because sugar cane requires warm climates. And in South India, along the annual year, the climate is very very warm. Then the Northern Plains, that means Gangetic Basin, when you consider the cultivation of the sugar cane. Okay? Therefore, even if you see, Uttar Pradesh is the highest producer of the sugarcane. Okay? Uttar Pradesh is one of the highest producer of the sugarcane. Yet, if you see the yield in the sense kya? Yield in the sense, how much crops are produced from a particular land. If you see the yield in percentage, then the yield of sugarcane is always higher in South India than in North India. Okay? Uttar Pradesh is higher producer of the sugarcane. It is because of the vast land it has which grows the sugarcane. Okay? So this was it. So temperature to hum jaan hi chuke hain. Now let's go, let's also see again according to temperature, different three seasons are there. So see, kharif season, rabi season, zaid season. Hum ye to sab kuch dekh chuke hain ki ye rainy hai, winter hai, summer hai. May, July also we have seen. Let's see the climate required for the growth. See, for kharif crops, I already told you. For sowing, it requires hot weather and lots of water. For rabi crop, warm climate, not very hot climate. And germination requires cold climate and little water. And zaid crops, these requires very, very less water and they can be grown in the dry climate. Okay, that's why zaid is nothing but summer crop. These are summer crops. Okay? Examples we already know. Do not forget these examples. ये examples पे directly objective question आ सकता है, कभी भी भूलना मत. Now let's go to the next factor which is affecting is rainfall. Rainfall का भी हम देख चुके that how India has different regions according to the rainfall distribution from 50 centimeter to 100 centimeter, 100 centimeter to 150 centimeter, 150 centimeter to 200, more than 200. According to that, the rainfall map distribution has been given and that relates to the cropping pattern or the cropping map of the country, which we discussed in agroclimatic zone. So if you see in rainfall, if you see is the determining factor for different crops which are grown. And if rainfall is determining different crops are grown, then rainfall will also determine different cropping patterns which are grown for the different crops. Okay, Am I audible? Okay. So now according to rainfall, three regions have been made. So first is cropping pattern in the areas of heavy rainfall. Now which could be these regions of heavy rainfall? So these regions are northeast region and western ghat region. So this is nothing but the areas of heavy rainfall. Is areas mein kya kya grow hota hai? Simple, rice, tea, coffee, sugarcane is almost grown here somewhere. Even in some of the Assam regions here, sugarcane is grown. Jute, West Bengal region, here jute is grown. Okay, so you could see that these areas have more than 150 centimeter rainfall, and as these are heavy rainfall region, these are the crops which are grown. So this is the first region under the rainfall factor. Okay, this also we have discussed very very in depth, so I don't think many of the people would be having doubt in this. Next is cropping pattern in areas of moderate to medium rainfall. So moderate rainfall is 75 to 150 centimeter. Okay, 75 to 150 centimeter. And what are these regions? These are nothing but Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Odisha, Eastern Madhya Pradesh and Vidarbha region of Maharashtra. So let's just check out. So relief we discussed in agroclimatic zones discussion. Temperature also we have discussed. Rainfalls here, this rainfall you could see, this is the first zone, green, heavy rainfall region. Blue region is moderate rainfall region and yellow region is less rainfall region. Three regions are shown which are having distinct cropping patterns because of rainfall as a factor. Okay, so this was nothing but our medium region. Okay, and yes, isohyat has been also mentioned. Isohyat, agar kisi ko pata nahi hai kya hai, let me tell you. Isohyats are those lines on the map, some lines are drawn. These lines connect those regions which are having same or similar rainfall. Okay, these are nothing but isohyats. And isotherms are the lines which join the region which are having same temperature. Those are isotherms. Okay, I think many of the people would be knowing this. But still, if anyone is not knowing it, don't worry, like we will clear everything. So now we got it, medium rainfall wala region ho gaya. Then comes low rainfall region. See here how much low the rainfall is. You could see how much the rainfall is low here. 25 to 75 centimeter, right? The region also we saw here, different millets as well as pulses would be grown. Okay, so jowar, bajra and different seeds, oil seeds are also grown. Okay, so if you want to see this region, this is nothing but, see here, this is the region, the yellow colored region which we talked about, less rainfall region. So the next factor is soil. Soil also as a factor we discussed in agroclimatic zone, but let's see it again. Okay, so different crops require different edaphic conditions. Edaphic conditions is nothing but like different profile of soils are there and soil characteristics are there. Depending on that, different crops require different cropping soil conditions for the growth. So first such condition is physical, that is irrigation, drainage and soil moisture. Okay, so how much water the soil could hold. For example, if you compare all alluvial soil with sandy soil, we compared it, you cannot grow wheat in sandy soil. Wo pani hold hi nahi kar pata. Rice in sandy soil, it cannot hold the water. So this example. Then is chemical. Chemical, that is soil nutrients, pH, salinity. In soil classification also we saw alkaline soils, acidic soils, alkaline soils and neutral soils. We saw it in last class only, last class of agroclimatic zones. Then biological, which bacteria, humus is present, earthworms are present in soil. So all these things are responsible for different crops to be grown and correspondingly different cropping patterns to be grown. Okay, then rice is mainly grown in clay soil and loamy soil is best for wheat. So then Deccan Plateau is ideal for cultivation of cotton because of its black soil. Okay, coarse grain such as jowar, bajra are grown in the inferior soil such as light sandy soils and laterite soils. Okay, so these were some of the examples. We already discussed kar chuke hum. So here one of the short thing to understand is that fertility of soil ऑलवेज इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द क्रॉप प्रोडक्टिविटी. जितना सॉइल अपना फर्टाइल रहेगा उतना क्रॉप प्रोडक्टिविटी अपनी हाई रहेगी. सो दार्जिलिंग हिल कंटेन सफिशियंट क्वांटिटीज ऑफ ह्यूमस, आयरन, पोटेशियम, फॉस्फरस, एंड दैट इज वाई दार्जिलिंग टी इज वेरी वेरी फेमस एंड हाई प्रोडक्शन ऑफ टी इज फ्रॉम द पर्टिकुलर एरिया. क्योंकि उसका सॉइल भी देखो कैसे इन्फ्लुएंस कर रहा है टी प्रोडक्शन को. देन डेल्टा सॉइल्स ऑफ वेस्ट बंगाल floods everywhere and therefore it is very very fertile and therefore West Bengal, according to latest economical survey, West Bengal is the highest producer of rice. Okay, then they are ideal for jute cultivation and farmers grow 2 to 3 crops in year in this region. Or rice to ugate hi hai West Bengal. Okay, then Ganga Brahmaputra basin for its sugar cane, for its rice, wheat as well as jute cultivation. Then this example, through this example we could understand, we saw this map also in the agroclimatic zones region and we saw how soil influences different crops and thus now the cropping patterns. Okay, then economic factors. Now here we have to discuss very very properly. See, in agroclimatic zones we only discussed about some of the geographical pattern factors, but cropping, for cropping patterns along with the geographical factors there are also certain factors such as economic factors. Now how economic factors will result into change in cropping pattern, ab dekhte hain ki kaise cropping pattern change ho sakta hai. See here, the irrigation power, size of land holding, sale of crops, income of farmers, insurance, investments are important for deciding the cropping pattern in an area. So for example, if a person is having good irrigation, automatically he has more edge than a person who is not having a irrigation along with him for its agricultural production. Okay, see here, for irrigation is an important input and it has a greater significance in arid and semi-arid areas. Okay, even if rainfall is there in particular areas, we have to understand that the irrigation is very very important. And as we all know, as major of the land in the Indian subcontinent is dependent on monsoon, and this monsoon is very very erratic, is very very invariable. Okay, so it is very variable climatic conditions these years after 2016. The monsoon has become very very unpredictable. Because of that, irrigation becomes very very important. Then irrigation is used in all cropping regions for high yields. North Indian plain regions are well irrigated and support 2 to 3 crops of rice a year. So as for a huge population like India, every farmer tries to produce more than one crop, and that is not going to happen because most of the farming lands are dependent on monsoon, and monsoon annually only comes one in kharif season only. Okay, so how the farmer will produce rice 3 times? It is because of irrigation. Okay, so then crop diversification in certain regions has been negligible due to the presence of irrigation. Okay, so as irrigation is available in lot for various regions, so therefore farmers goes on producing rice and rice only because of the availability of the water. Okay, why the live class is not showing in the app? This is my first class. Check it. I am live. See, in my mobile it is on. आप थोड़ा फिर से लॉग आउट करके लॉग इन कर लो. आई गेस फिर चल जाएगा. रेस्ट ऑफ द गाइज प्लीज लेट मी नो कि ऐप में वगैरह कोई लाइक इज द लेक्चर गोइंग लाइव. प्लीज लेट मी नो. Agnik, you log out and then again log in. क्योंकि मेरे मोबाइल फोन में दिखा रहा है लेक्चर. यू डोंट वरी, इवन इफ यू मिस समथिंग, दिस सेशन वुड बी इज बींग रिकॉर्डेड एंड इट वुड बी अपलोडेड, तो वहां पर जाके भी देख सकते हो. इट इज शोइंग नोटिफिकेशन कम्स ऑन डैशबोर्ड. इट इज ओके ओके, इट इज शोइंग. या ओके, लेट्स कंटिन्यू देन. So then its crop diversification in certain regions has been negligible. Yeah, this we did. Example, rice dominates in well irrigated parts of South India, wheat dominates in northwestern part of the country, and core grains like jowar, bajra, maize, barley are given comparatively less importance in this region. So very good example has been taken here. South India and Gangetic Basin, northwestern part of the country, yahan par irrigation bahut hai. इरिगेशन मतलब वाटर अवेलेबिलिटी बहुत है, इसलिए लोग वहां पर कभी भी ये कोर्स ग्रेन जैसे कि जोवर, बाजरा, मेज, बार्ली, इनका प्लांटेशन करते भी नहीं है. देयर आर टू रीजंस फॉर इट. फर्स्ट, द जोवर, बाजरा, कोर्स ग्रेन्स डोंट हैव दैट मच वैल्यू इन मार्केट एज कंपेयर टू राइस एंड व्हीट. okay? And second thing, they are having ample amount of water through the well irrigated means available to them, okay? So therefore, if you see, the coarse grains are always grown in dryland regions, in the regions where water is scarce, such as central India, okay? Then canals and dams in arid and semi-arid regions have also been proving blessing for wheat and rice production in various regions in the India. Green Revolution का हमने जब agroclimatic zones में example लिया था, we took an example of Indira Gandhi Canal, that how it has been a lifeline for the overall Green Revolution patch in the northwestern region. Okay? Then its size of the land holding. अब size of the land holding कैसे influence करेगा cropping pattern को? Simple. If there is a farmer who is a marginal farmer, so marginal farmer के पास he may be having less than 5 hectare of holding, right? If he is having less than 5 hectare of holding, can he use huge tractors? Can he use different 4, 5, 6 crops for combinations in his field? ये बताओ, ये हो सकता है क्या? Just let me know, क्या ये हो सकता है? अगर मैं suppose एक farmer हूँ और मेरे पास 1 hectare to 3 hectare का farm है, okay? And in that farm, if I want to plant 5 crops, is it possible? Of course, it's not possible. Because if I am planting 4 to 5 crops in just small patch of land, how much irrigation I would require? How much technology, how much tractors I would require? How much labor I would require, right? So therefore, the land holding is also responsible for the different cropping pattern in the country, okay? So farmers with large holding can opt for cash and help in crop diversification, leading to changes in the cropping pattern. Okay, so that's what it means. Jis farmer ke paas land huge hota hai, jaise ki 10-20 bigha zameen, bahut badi badi zameen rehti hai. So such huge or such rich farmers can only do the cropping of the commercial farming, jaise ki commercial farming of sugar cane, commercial farming of tree is done by only one farmer who has a huge land under his garb. Okay, but when you compare such a rich farmer with a poor farmer, he cannot do the same which has been done by the rich farmer. It is only because of the land holding. Then subsistence farming. Farmers who grow food grains sufficient for the family members in small land holdings. Okay, and ye statistics jo 2010-2011 ka hai, you could see here that 67.1%, देखो कितना marginal farmers कितने ज़्यादा है इंडिया में, 67.1% ये पूरा section is nothing but marginal farmers. That means this much farmers are having less than 5 hectare holding, and you tell me how they could do commercial farming, you tell me how they can do more than 2-3 crops of cropping pattern or crop cultivation. That's not possible, okay? So this was the point. In spite of crop diversification potential, we want to do crop diversification. We want that farmers should grow more than 2-3 crops per agricultural annual year. But still it is not possible because of the land holding, fragmentation of land which we discussed, okay? So now, So this was the irrigation, this is the irrigation topic which we were discussing before the land holding. So total geographical area is 329 million hectares. The gross cropped area is 195 million hectares. The net sown area is 142. That means if a person is having 142 million hectares of land, in context of whole of the country, then the gross cropped area, that means the more than one or more than two crops are grown, that land is 195. Out of this 142, 95 is rain fed. That means 67% area is rain fed and only 33% is irrigated in the country. So see how much irrigation is required in the country. 67% area bus monsoon pe dependent hai. So kitna is India mein irrigation ki requirement hai, we would understand how much grim the situation is. Okay? Now this was nothing but the crop we were looking at land holding, right? Land holding ko dekh rahe the hum. So land holding we understood, less the land holding, less the farmer would be having chance for diversification, less the farmer would be having the chance for multiple cropping or changing his cropping pattern. ओके. सो नेक्स्ट इज अवेलेबल ऑफ इनपुट्स एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट. सिंपल, इफ यू हैव मोर मनी विथ यू, यू कैन प्लांट मोर क्रॉप्स, यू कैन डू मोर क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न्स, राइट. इफ यू हैव लेस मनी, हाउ कुड यू डू मोर देन वन क्रॉप? इट्स वेरी सिंपल, डायरेक्ट पॉइंट है अवेलेबल इनपुट्स. सो एग्रीकल्चरल इनपुट्स सच एज सीड्स, फर्टिलाइजर्स, वाटर स्टोरेज, इरिगेशन में भी, ट्रांसपोर्ट एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा, दे ऑल्सो इन्फ्लुएंस द क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न. ओके, सो मेन रीजन फॉर रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ कॉटन इन मध्य प्रदेश, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू सी द इवोल्यूशन ऑफ द कॉटन कल्टिवेशन इन द कंट्री, देर वर थ्री स्टेट्स विच वेर हाई प्रोड्यूसर्स ऑफ द कॉटन, द मुंबई रीजन, द गुजरात रीजन एंड द मध्य प्रदेश रीजन. बट द मध्य प्रदेश रीजन डिडंट हैड अवेलेबल इनपुट्स एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट, देर फॉर दे रिप्लेस दिस कॉटन विद द ग्राउंडनट सीड्स. एंड टूडे इफ यू सी द पार्ट्स ऑफ द मध्य प्रदेश विच वेर अर्लियर ग्रोइंग कॉटन्स, नाउ दे आर कल्टिवेटिंग ग्राउंडनट्स. ओके, सो दिस इज नथिंग बट दी अवेलेबल इनपुट्स. आई थिंक वी आर मोर देन क्लियर हियर अवेलेबल इनपुट्स में, इतना कुछ बड़ा है नहीं इसमें. देन इज इंश्योरेंस एंड रिस्क. सो सिंपल सी बात है, अगर आपके पास इंश्योरेंस है, यू वुड बी मोर फ्री, यू वुड द फार्मर्स वॉन्ट हैव मोर स्ट्रेस, सो ऑटोमेटिकली दे वुड गो फॉर डाइवर्सिफिकेशन, दे वुड गो फॉर डूइंग मोर प्रोडक्टिव एग्रीकल्चर. सो लेट्स सी हियर थ्रू अ डायग्राम, सी हियर डाइवर्सिफिकेशन ऑफ क्रॉप्स, क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न. देखो, इंश्योरेंस की वजह से लो रिस्क, लो रिस्क परस्यू एग्रीकल्चर विदाउट फियर, दिस प्रिवेंट्स फार्मर्स टू सफर हैवी लॉसेस, दिस गिव्स कुशंस टू फार्मर एंड देयरफॉर रिजल्ट्स इन डाइवर्सिफिकेशन एज वेल एज द चेंज इन द क्रॉपिंग पैटर्न. ओके, सो दिस वॉज नथिंग बट द इंश्योरेंस पॉइंट. सो देन इज वैल्यू. So value is nothing but, see, if a crop is having high value, then farmer will always try to produce it more, right? So for example, millets are grown in hilly regions of Himachal Pradesh and Uttarakhand are replaced by the high value horticultural crops. So earlier, agar hum dekhe, तो हिमाचल प्रदेश और उत्तराखंड रीजन में पहले मिलेट्स ग्रो किए जाते थे, लेग्यूम्स पल्सेस ग्रो किए जाते थे, बट दीज मिलेट्स एंड लेग्यूम्स एंड पल्सेस आर हैविंग वेरी लो वैल्यू इन मार्केट एज कंपेयर टू द हाई हॉर्टिकल्चरल वैल्यू. देयरफॉर टुडे इफ यू सी दैट हॉर्टिकल्चरल वाइज हिमाचल प्रदेश एंड उत्तराखंड आर लीडिंग स्टेट्स इन दैट प्रोड्यूसर एंड ऑल द फार्मर्स इन दैट पर्टिकुलर रीजन आर ग्रोइंग दिस हॉर्टिकल्चरल फ्लावर्स, फ्रूट्स एंड डिफरेंट डिफरेंट हॉर्टिकल्चरल क्रॉप्स which are having very high viability in the market. Okay, unko prices bahut high milte hai as compared to millets. So therefore this could be an example of value, how value of a particular crop in a market changes the cropping pattern of a particular region. Then comes the demand sell price of the crops and the income of the farmers. See, rice is preferred crop in the densely populated region as here the rice in the market, the demand for the rice would be more. So for example, rice is grown high in Uttar Pradesh, in Maharashtra, in Gujarat, right? Because these states are highly populated and here the demand of rice would never fall. Yahan par rice ki demand kabhi giregi hi nahi. See, farmer suicides वगैरह ये जो problem है agricultural crisis के, agricultural systems could be one of the solution for it. Okay, overall solutions बहुत सारे हैं and these all have to work in tandem to solve the agricultural crisis. Okay, rest from that I don't think बाकी कोई major doubts है. Even agricultural census shows. हाँ, करेक्ट करेक्ट, एग्रीकल्चर सेंसस से ये पता चलता है दैट क्रॉप जो लैंड है दैट इज रिड्यूसिंग, राइट, लैंड होल्डर्स, यस, लैंड होल्डर्स एंड द फ्रेगमेंटेशन ऑफ लैंड इज हैपनिंग इन द कंट्री, दैट इज ऑल्सो बीन मेंशन्ड, यस, एग्जैक्टली, करेक्ट है ये. देन डिमांड एंड सेल प्राइस ऑफ द क्रॉप्स एंड द इनकम्स ऑफ फार्मर, इससे हमें क्या पता लगना था, दैट राइस का जो डिमांड है इन अ पॉपुलेटेड स्टेट दैट वुड नेवर फॉल, राइट. सो हियर द फार्मर्स वुड प्रोड्यूस राइस मोर, एम आई राइट. सिमिलरली फार्मर्स हु वॉन्ट टू सेल द क्रॉप्स एट हाइएस्ट प्राइस वॉन्ट टू गेट देयर हाइएस्ट अमाउंट ऑफ प्रोडक्ट. सो यहां पर एक एग्जाम्पल ले लेते, जस्ट टेक एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ फार्मर हु इज फ्रॉम आंध्र प्रदेश. सिंपल सी बात है, पहले आंध्र प्रदेश का ये फार्मर राइस प्रोड्यूस कर रहा था, लेकिन राइस उसको एमएसपी के अकॉर्डिंग बस बहुत कम पैसे में मिल रहा था, 16 रुपए राइस, 18 रुपए राइस. फार्मर को चाहिए था बहुत पैसा, ही नीडेड मोर मनी. तो फार्मर ने ये देखा मार्केट में कि जो जो टोमेटो ग्रो कर रहे हैं उनको टोमेटोज तो हाई प्राइस में मिल रहा है, बिकॉज टोमेटोज आर मोर देन 80 रुपीज पर केजी, राइट. सो देयरफॉर फार्मर्स ने क्या किया, इन 2019 दे वेर प्रोड्यूसिंग राइस, बट इन 2020 दे थॉट दैट वी शुड प्रोड्यूस टोमेटोज. सो डोमिनो इफेक्ट, फ्रॉम 2019 ऑल द फार्मर्स इन द आंध्र प्रदेश दे स्टार्टेड प्रोड्यूसिंग टोमेटोज, एंड दिस in a hope to get more profitability or more money. Okay, so this is nothing but the demand, sell price of the crops and income of the farmers, this changes the cropping pattern. So 2019 mein cropping pattern different tha, kyunki tab rice produce kar raha tha Andhra Pradesh ka farmer, lekin abhi wo zyada paise kamana chahta hai, that's why he is producing more tomatoes, right. So this could be also connected to the example of green revolution. Kyun? Before green revolution coarse grain were there. After green revolution, automatically rice and wheat has been dominating the food basket. Similarly, domino effect which we discussed of the Andhra Pradesh farmer, and MSP post effect also. So if you observe, when MSP came into the picture in the Indian agricultural system, after the MSP of the service of the MSP, we could see that farmers are growing those crops which are giving them high MSP returns. Matlab MSP agar ek crop ki high hai, तो प्रोबेबिलिटी ये ज्यादा है कि फार्मर उसी क्रॉप को प्रोड्यूस करेगा. क्यों? क्योंकि एमएसपी का रिटर्न उसको ज्यादा मिलेगा. सिंपल. सो एंड देन तो ये पॉइंट आई थिंक डिमांड सेल प्राइस ऑफ द क्रॉप्स एंड द इनकम, दिस इज वेरी वेरी क्लियर. सो नाउ लेट्स गो टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज गवर्नमेंट पॉलिसीज एंड पॉलिटिकल फैक्टर्स. सो गवर्नमेंट पॉलिसीज एंड पॉलिटिकल फैक्टर्स, so these are nothing but government policies. पहली policy MSP है, MSP which we discussed. MSP is nothing but a basic minimum support price given for a particular crop according to which the different crops are grown. Similarly, this is nothing but fertilizer policy. The first fertilizer policy was product based subsidy. Then was nutrient based subsidy. Then was neem coated urea, and then is 2015 new urea policy 2015. Okay, so these fertilizer policy also have transformed the cropping pattern. Similarly goes for subsidies, farm loan waivers, land policy in the country. This all the governmental policies influence the cropping pattern. And so different legislative and administrative policies such as land acts, food crops acts, fertilizer policies, different agricultural policies, they also are responsible for changing the cropping pattern. Okay, so you could take an example here that how increase in cultivation of food grains over the cultivation of poppy, indigo, tobacco are largely because of government. Okay, and government can change the cropping pattern by strengthening the different rural transportations also. Okay, so here the minimums of the MSP example is given. For example, rice, wheat are grown more in the country because their MSP prices are also high. Okay, so we have discussed that these are very very generic points to understand. So I don't think like anybody would be having doubt in this section. Okay, so last point is historical factors. So history, according to history also different cropping patterns changed. How? So ब्रिटिशर्स ने क्या किया, टी प्लांटेशंस के लिए डिफरेंट टी प्लांटेशंस उन्होंने नॉर्थ ईस्ट में स्टार्ट किए. ओके, एंड सी टुडे टिल 2022 दार्जिलिंग टी इज फेमस इन द वर्ल्ड. बट किसने स्टार्ट किया आसाम में टी प्लांटेशन, ब्रिटिशर्स हैव स्टार्टेड इट. दिस इज हाउ हिस्टोरिकल फैक्टर्स आर ऑल्सो अफेक्टिंग. सिमिलरली टेक्सटाइल मिल्स वेर फर्स्ट इस्टेब्लिश्ड इन गुजरात रीजन एंड बॉम्बे प्रोविंस, एंड एज टेक्सटाइल्स ऑफ कॉटन वेर स्टार्टेड इन दिस रीजन फर्स्ट, the surrounding region is a cotton producing region. So Madhya Pradesh le lo, Gujarat le lo, the Vidarbha Marathwada and Maharashtra region le lo, the Deccan Plateau, overall Deccan Plateau is high producer of cotton plantation. Why? Because textiles were first established in Gujarat and Mumbai province. Okay, Bombay province. So this is how historical patterns. Similarly, sugarcane is extensively grown in North India, even if the favorable conditions are in South India. We talked about the higher yield. Okay, and why this happened? This is because sugarcane cultivation was enforced by Britishers on the northern Indian farmers. Why? Because indigo farming lost its significance because of the dyes, artificial colors which came into the market. So indigos farmers cultivate करना बंद कर दिए. अब indigo cultivation बंद कर दिया तो अब क्या करेंगे? तो उन्होंने sugarcane cultivation start किया. So this is how. And similarly post green revolution, कैसे green revolution ने history change कर दी. Now we are trying to do evergreen revolution. We are not trying to do green revolution 2.0. We are not trying to do that. Similarly, so this is how historical factors transform. Okay. So see here, this is nothing but cropping pattern. Visualize it. देखो different cropping patterns है. शायद यहाँ पर तुमने rice लगाया, यहाँ पर तुमने legumes लगाए. And this is the holistic thing of cropping patterns and its interaction with different components of agriculture is cropping system. Okay. So here we will stop and tomorrow we will do classification of cropping system. Okay. तो कल हम cropping system cropping systems का classification करेंगे. हम देखेंगे कि कैसे different different crops के different different combinations है और different different cropping patterns है. उसका पूरा classification देखेंगे. Okay. So I think we will end the lesson here. Thank you very much. Okay. And see you tomorrow. Okay.